What's up, everybody? This is the 272nd day of Make It Sombrier. And today I'm going to be working on Rock's bike. I got the game. So you can wander around the actual ship Songbringer a lot more now. Before, in the last alpha release, you could wander around just two rooms of the ship. And you'd never started there. So it was kind of, you didn't really know you needed to start there. Or you didn't even know that it was available to go to that area. So now the game is actually going to start on Songbringer. Eventually there's going to be a whole story and plot and everything. But the gist is basically your ship arrives on this new planet. You just finish playing a live show. You have sort of like an indie band. Or not an indie band, but more of like just an amateur band. You know, you're not a professional rock star or anything, but you still play music. The hero Rock plays music. So yeah, it's not going to start that way in the latest version. There's going to be a lot more story to be added, but in the meantime, you'll at least be able to wander around the ship a little bit. So some stuff I've got to do today is, you know, I got to fix up these lava lamps. So, you know, stagger the way they float, and also get them so their Z is correct. So right now, if I walk down here, it's kind of an optical illusion here. You think that this is should be, you know, further down, or it should be, but you should be in front of it there. So that'd be more natural to get like that. This is pretty sweet to be able to at least wander around the ship finally. Here's the droid smith where you craft items. Here's where you get the cup. Over here, this room is actually going to be an observation deck. So there'll be big windows right here, looking out on the world, or you know, space if you're up in space. And then also over here, there's the hangar. And this is what I'm going to work on next: is the hangar. So it's not really a hangar; it's more just like a place where your bike is. So I'm going to work on the bike, make it so you can get on the bike, and you take off and you fly. And then, yeah, there'll eventually be a cutscene there too. So you'll be flying in the air, going down to the planet. But for now, it's just gonna fade out, and then you wake up on the planet and you've crashed the bike. So once again, there's a lot of story to add, but I at least want to have the mechanics and the base of everything created here. So that's what I'm working on. Oh, I forgot about. Hold on a second. Forgot about the chat window. What's up with me today, huh? Sorry, everybody. Yeah, there we go. All right. Okay, so yeah, so next thing, let's put the player in the hangar. I'm just gonna call it a hangar for now, even though it's more of just a platform. So there's gonna need to be some more light. I want light coming in from over to the right. Actually, there'll be big windows to the right of the screen. But first of all, I want to make it so the bike has... Actually, maybe I'll put one more lamp in here. But I want the bike to be thicker to start with. Beta Barney, what's up, man? How you doing? Let's see what this looks like with one more light in the hangar. Thank you. Perhaps a little less width offset. Yeah, it's kind of cool. So it is flickering these lights. I guess these are kind of flickery lights. It's all right. Okay, so yeah, I want to make this. I want to get bring a lot more depth into the bike. Right now, it's really 2D. So I'm gonna customize this out, make this way better. Boogie, what's up? Yeah, the lava lamps, right? All right. The width of this bike is probably about the thickness of one of these tires. This side is 3 pixels. This side is about 4 pixels. 5 pixels. Let's say 4. So on average, the tire width is about 4. Adding a little bit more for the seat and everything, that's going to be maybe more like 6 pixels wide. Or I'm thinking more of voxels. If this was actually a three-dimensional thing, this would be 6 pixels wide approximately. So at this angle, for this perspective of this game, that should be 6 pixels times about 0.16, 0.6. So about 4 pixels. Dyson fans? Oh yeah. Whoa, dude. What? I've never seen these. That's awesome. Wow. Gotta get one of these. Dude, learn something new every day. Right? Yeah. Nope, they don't turn. They don't even meant to turn. It's just a flying bike. It just looks like an old school bike. Okay, so yeah, 4 pixels wide, which means that if, for example, this top of that, first of all, oh, I did try a different bike look. Okay, so first of all, yeah, first of all, I should make a copy of that. And then this will start going wild. Actually, if I did copies, let's see what happens if I just. So there we go. That looks weird, right? With this just duplicating the top, but that gives you the right perspective. So let me save this first. Yeah, there'll be lots of other cutscenes. Yeah, there one of the cutscenes will be Rock flying on his bike right here. Another one is the beginning of the game. The ship approaches the planet, and there'll be ending cutscenes. There's a few middle cutscenes as well when the story kind of advances and the last dungeon appears and all that. What's up, J2? So let's see what this looks like. with that depth. Before I go and touch this up and make it any better, I just want to see if that depth looks about right. Wait for this thing to repack the textures. Yeah, I can't wait to do the cutscenes, but those are probably going to be a few months down the road. Because I want to finish the core game first. Yeah, there we go. Oh my God. Helps so much. Oh yeah. Cool. Now it's a three-dimensional object. Before it was a two-dimensional object. Okay, that looks good, but I do want to do some touch-ups. Was like, why isn't my pen working? But I had it like this. I was like, ugh. Okay, before I do this, I want to touch up this first two-dimensional bike, make it cleaner, and I'm debating. I kind of want to. I want to make the back wheel a little bigger, or the front wheel a little smaller. In fact, let me think. Yeah, the stream loaded right on, Arcane. What's up, dude? Happy today! Happy today! Yeah, I'm thinking the back wheel should be as big as the front wheel. Yeah, I guess so. Question on Twitter, you use WizardFoo. Oh yeah, this is a really great question, Beta Barney. What should you do as a developer? What should you do as far as creating a Twitter handle that is for you personally, or do you want a Twitter handle for your game? Is that right? Is that how I'm reading this? Let me read this again. Not a specific account for Songbringer. Right. Yeah. So basically, so you could either have an account for yourself or slash your business, whatever, or you're thinking you have an actual Twitter account for your game. And I did debate on that for so much before I started this, and I was looking at other developers a lot, going, "What are other people doing? What should I do? What should I do? Should I create it for just a WizardFoo account, or should I create a Songbringer account?" And, I think it kind of boils down to a matter of preference. I really don't think it as long as you're genuine about what you're doing, I think, you know what I mean? If you're on Twitter, whoa, my pen just broke. That's so weird. Sorry. If you're on Twitter and your point is what was I trying to say about this? Yeah, so here's why I didn't create both. Boogie's got a good suggestion here. Create both, right? You got one account for your business or your personal alias. You got one for your game. I didn't do that because I didn't want to put all this time and energy into creating an account for both for one of them and not put some energy into enough energy into both of them. You know what I mean? If I had two Twitter accounts, I would not be able to be as genuine and awesome to other people if I, you know. Are you guys feeling me on this? Basically, I can't. I'm only one man. And so I think in my case, in my personal case as a one person solo developer, it works really well to have just a single account. It becomes really easy to follow me. You know clearly what I'm posting all the time. I'm making the game called Songbringer right now. And if you're following me, you're kind of following Songbringer at this point. But down the road, I might be creating something else like Songbringer 2 or Songbringer 3. And I don't want to go have create a Songbringer 2 Twitter account. I don't want to create a Songbringer 3 Twitter account. I don't want to divide my own energies. on that on Twitter, because I really think Twitter is an amazing tool. It's a great communication platform. And so I think for me, it makes it more genuine and more natural and just kind of better overall to do one account. And so I decided to do just an account for Wizard Foo. And that way it's clear. You know, it's clear for following me too. If you're following me on Twitter, you know what you're getting. You don't have to worry whether it's about this or that. It's just this. But yeah, I hope that's kind of probably confusing insight there, but I hope that helped. You said you noticed Vlambeer just uses Vlambeer. Yeah. So quite a few other people are doing that too. That's cool. It's good to know. Can always create more accounts. Yeah, see, I don't like using those programs that manage multiple accounts. I don't think you get into the social network in the proper way if you're using those kind of softwares. Yeah, he has six accounts. See, but then the, see the I think the downside to having multiple accounts is like if you're a follower, which one do you follow? You know? It's confusing. It's not as clear. So I think it's clear if you just have one account. But that's my opinion. So I get, and again, that works, you know, probably works better for other people or not. Okay, man. Yeah, good. And either way you go, just stick with it. You know what I mean? Once you've gone a certain direction and you've started communicating in a certain way, you really want to stick to it. If you start changing your accounts or changing your name or changing anything really at all about, not really changing anything, but changing your name, basically. You never want to change your name. You never really want to change your the clarity of what you're doing, you know? Keep it clear. That's my opinion. What's up, Unitas? How do you even get into using Twitter? Oh yeah, well, that's a great question too. Gosh, you know what? And I thought the same thing. I always never had a Twitter. I actually never had a Twitter account until just last November. So I've only had a Twitter account for a year. And I always thought it was silly. I was like, dude, Twitter's silly. Twitter's this, Twitter's that. But when I finally got into it, I did it. I got into it this way. I started following stuff that really was dope to me. I was like, dude, it is so cool to check out this guy's pixel art. And I was learning to make pixel art at the time, and it became so interesting. Like Pixels Huh was one of my first, the first people I ever followed on Twitter, and I still to this day I love getting Pixels Huh. I think it's Pixels Huh. Yeah, Pixels Huh. He does some rad pixel art. So this is what you should do, man. If you really want to get into Twitter, only follow the stuff that you think is dope. You know what I mean? Follow the most interesting things you can. Don't worry about trying to get other followers. Just focus on the cool stuff that interests you. And then it'll become a joy to actually check your Twitter. I do that in the morning, like for, you know, for a good 5, 15 minutes or whatever in the morning every day. I'm always like checking Twitter. Not every day, but I check Twitter a lot. It's fun. Look at all this rad pixel art I can go like soak up. You know what I mean? It inspires me. It's really fun to check Twitter. So make it fun, man. That's my suggestion. In any kind of social network or any kind of marketing or whatever, keep your marketing fun, dude. It's great to do stuff like that where, you know, on one hand, marketing could be a chore. On the other hand, marketing could be fun. Which one do you want? You know, make it that way. Make it somehow make it that way. Figure out how to make it that way. Arcane. Yeah, good point, Arcane, right? Yeah. Sometimes it does, sometimes it totally makes sense if you're a developer and you have three games you're working on at once, which I can't even contemplate. But yeah. So it works for some people where it doesn't work for others. Dude, Bit of Barney, that's really smart of you to do your Twitter account and set it up the way you want and do it the right way from the start. Yeah. Awesome, man. Cool. Okay, so going back to this, I want to clean up the pixels for this. his bike. And make the back wheel about as big as the front wheel. So I'm just going to move this other wheel out of the way. But kind of keep it for reference. Actually, I'm going to duplicate it. Make it a little bigger. This is getting crazy. I need a bigger canvas. Ah. So, how's everybody doing today? What's new in the world? What have I missed recently? I'm always missing stuff. Yeah, I use a MIDI controller. It's not really a, yeah, I would call it a MIDI controller, but it's like, this is what it, can you see this? I think you guys can see this. This is my MIDI controller. I have it on a stand so that I can play it standing up, but it's a 16 pad thingy. It's an M Audio trigger finger. They don't actually make these anymore. But this kind of device is really easy to find. It's just got pressure sensitive pads and 16 of them. That's really all I use. I don't use the knobs or anything. And it doubles as a laptop stand. Nice. Yeah. And so I always make my drum beats with that. So they're always natural, you know? Man, it's kind of hot in here today. It looked like it'd be hot outside, but it feels like it is. So is that the right height now? Nope. That seems way too big now. Nice, cool. You made music in college? Awesome. How's this bike gonna be used? Check it out. You're at the very beginning of the game. It's the only thing I'm struggling with. Yeah, get into it, man. Yeah, just get into it. Once you get back into it, if you already done it, so once you get back into it, it'll be just like, it'll be so natural. You're like, oh, music. You start the game actually, when the game actually is all done and complete, and you play the final game, you're going to start at one screen below this. But for now, you're going to start here in the middle, and there'll be a few people here, like smoking cigarettes and stuff or whatever. And basically, the way when the game finally is done, you're going to start here. You actually start the game playing a lot, playing live music. There'll be a drum set here. There'll be huge, giant speakers right here and right here. There'll be a guitar on the stage. And you're basically playing guitar. Jib is playing the drums, I'm thinking. Somehow, Jib plays the drums. And that's it. There's all these people rocking out here at the bottom. And so you're done playing your song. You put down the guitar. Everybody's starts mingling and stuff. And then you go up. That starts your adventure, right? You're basically, this ship, Songbringer, has landed, not landed, but gone to into the atmosphere of the planet. And is hovering there, and you come out and you're like, oh, you talk to some people or whatever. And over here, you grab the cup. If you're smart, you grab the cup. And then there's also this room over here where you've got the droid smith where you can craft items. You can't really do anything there yet, but I'm sure there'll be some kind of story that lets you know that. And then there's your bike. So you hop on your bike, and then you fly off, and you start your adventure. You crash the bike on the planet, and that's the start of it. Right, the cup, yeah. If only he knew how important the cup was. All right, this is looking kind of janky, but I'm just gonna get the sizing and proportions down first. Oops. Yeah. Nice, right on. All right, so I'm going to rotate the bike and make it level now. In fact, I should do a little ground line. Yeah, definitely Tron-like feel. Totally. Yep, it's meant to be a Tron bike, kind of, but unique. So I'm trying to make it a little more unique at this point. Yeah. Yep, Tron-inspired bike for sure. Okay, let's see what happens if I rotate this. Yeah, now it's starting to look more badass. That bigger back wheel. There we go. Now let's just hope that it keeps it. It almost looks like the back wheel is bigger than the front wheel now. But I don't know, I kind of like that. Yeah, I think I'm gonna keep it. I'm gonna keep him. Wait, maybe not. Maybe just a little less. Yeah, like that. And then I can kind of. Right? I only need one pixel for that bottom. No, that's too much. Oh, it'd be cool to give it a strut or something, maybe. Yeah, totally. I'm not, yeah, exactly. I'm like, this is totally rough, right? I'm just trying to get proportions down first and overall rotation first. Let's see what that looks like. Let's give it a strut. Oh no. No. Oh, there we go. I was like, what's wrong with my tablet again? Right, a little strut thingy. Whoops. Okay, so I don't know. I want to see what this looks like in the game with the kind of with the strut. So I'm just gonna do this whole duplication thing again to give it some thickness and just and like I said, this is totally junky pixels, but wait, first of all. There. Okay. Whoops. I totally messed all that up. Okay, so junky pixel proportion text test. Oh, I don't know if it copied. Oh, it did. I almost think it needs to re-rotate it a little more. So back in time, let's do that again. It needs to, I think it needs, I like the rotation where it had a, it seemed like the back wheel was bigger. Just playing around with these positions and stuff. I don't know whether I like the strut or the not strut. Think I'm gonna go with the semi almost strut. Right, let's work with this. Actually, okay, I should test it one more time. Yeah, J2, cool idea. Unconnected wheels. I like that. Oh, yeah, then the bike could sit there hovering. Sweet idea. I love it. Oh, Arcane. Oh, sorry, I missed you saying that. Sorry, man. Arcane said that like 2 seconds ago. Yeah. My apologies. My apologies. Definitely, thanks for keeping me in line. Sometimes I don't notice everything. Okay, let's get. Yeah, I'm gonna check this one more time. Check the proportions, and then we'll start making it cool. So, right? Okay, last check. I'll hope this is the last check. Just want to get this rotation just right first, so then when I do all the work, to make it look right, that it's got the right rotational feeling. Oh, that's the old one. Just repacked. I was like, wait, this doesn't look like it's different. Yeah, that's a little better. Okay, done. Like it like this. Cool. I'm thinking of it floating. Definitely seems cool to me. What's up, Jonah 19? Ooh, that's even better with a back like that, just a pixel. Okay, and yeah, I'm gonna separate these pieces for now, and then work on them individually. Yeah, totally. Definitely just subtle. Yeah, definitely subtle. Oh, you didn't get an email today? That's weird. I think it's been going for looks like 40 minutes now, and I've had a lot of drop frames. I don't know what's up with that. But it hasn't stopped streaming yet, so it's been okay. Okay, each one of these wheels. Oh no. Oh. I think my pen's breaking again. Dude. All these months of the pen working good, and now it's stopping. So I really need to separate these all the way at first. But I do want to keep it right at the same Y. There we go. Okay, so this is going to allow me to make the tires thicker. Oh. Well, if you're just using Photoshop for retouching and photo manipulations, you probably don't need to do it as much unless you're using the actual retouching tools, right? If you're using the Band-Aid or whatever or brush tool, then yeah, this is like a beautiful brush and a beautiful pen, but not necessarily needed for if you're just doing filters and stuff. You know, it's a tool. It's meant for a certain thing. Certain task, I guess, is the right word, right? Oh, well then, yeah, if you're using all the tools, then yeah, I would imagine it would help. Hold on a sec, I gotta get some water.
Thirsty today.
Yeah, the price. You just get one. You don't need to get the awesomest one in the world. I think mine costs like $80, and there's still a version like it that's $80. It's even better now. And there's a couple companies that make it in that price range too. So oh, cool. Wacom Bamboo Manga Edition. Yeah, it's about, yeah, right, that one. Yeah, that's basically the version I have now, but yours is newer. Mine's just like old from 2011 or whatever. What's up, Kofez? How you doing today? Yeah, no, I've used Visual Studio. I started using Visual Studio. Actually, before I ever used an IDE, I actually edited all my code in MS-DOS edit and then compiled it on the command line. And that was the C language. And then I moved on to Windows 95 where I forget what I was using to compile back. I think it was Visual Studio. I think Visuals. Yeah, no, I remember it now. There was Visual C++ back then. You had to pay for it. It was like $300 just to buy Visual C++. There was no such thing as Visual Studio then. And then I moved on to using Visual Studio. And that was in the early 2000s. I was still only using Visual Studio, not even on Macs. And then in the late 2000s, I started using Macs. And then right around 2010 was when I finally actually got Xcode and started coding for iOS and Mac and all that. So, and then today, today there's so many great cross-platform engines that it doesn't really matter what platform you're developing on. You can publish to anything. Yeah, right, yeah. I know, I'm probably so used to this tablet that I wouldn't want anything else. Whoa, dude, $20? That's a deal, smoking. Get two of them. Yeah, this wheel's looking cool now. Much cleaner. Maybe, yeah, that's okay there. But this bottom bit's a little lumpy. Yeah, it works right on. As long as it is, dude, as long as it's, dude, this, it really doesn't matter how great it is. The whole point is getting used to using a pen and a tablet. You know, I'm so comfortable. I'm actually more comfortable doing art with the pen than without at this point. And that's really where you want to be, because I'm in a powerful state. I can create anything and create it quickly. So I highly recommend getting a tablet, even if it's just to get used to it. Because one day you might find yourself in the position where you're like, dude, this is one of the most, this is my favorite tool, you know? How to link two static libraries into one DLL? Yeah, there's I check out Rapid Game. I do it in Rapid Game, I do it on multiple platforms. So go check out github.com, NatWee's Rapid Game, and check out. Let's see. Let me see if I can find the code really quick for you. It's in RapidGame.js. And on Windows it links, and on Mac it links. Here's pre-build Android, pre-build Windows. Okay, so after it pre-builds, it does a link. Here's link Windows. Here we go. Here it is. So you need lib. The command is lib.exe on Windows. You need to be able to find that command, right? It's libexe path. You got to find your libexe, and then you just, you know, you can use the, check out the, just check out lib.exe on Windows. Sorry, man. That's all you need. But that, there's that code if you want to check that out. Right, Arcane. Yeah, I do that too. I'm in Mac, it's so much quicker to me to use the tablet. Oh yeah. I hear you. I'm not a fan of wireless input devices myself, because they run out of batteries. But that's why I always get wired stuff. Even my Xbox controller is the wired version. Oh, see, I see what you mean, Arcane. I see what you mean. See, I would highly recommend just getting the pen, and even just to get used to it, because you never know when it might become your favorite tool. Wait, this bottom's still a little lumpy there. Big Mac. Nice, you're working on an app icon, right on. Can you say a tip? Of course, man. Please show your tip. What's up, porn? Yeah, automatically typing Q, 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 Q. Yeah, mine did that too. And I never ever got one again. I was like, dude, these suck. Yeah, me too. Me too. Yeah. Man, this bottom edge looks so sharp to me right there. Is that better? Not really. Like that? No. I think that's just going to have to stay like that. Okay, that wheel, I'm pretty sure, is almost done. So, next wheel. Yeah, you despise wires. Yeah, I hear you, man. If I had started using wireless stuff later, maybe I would have gotten like, you know, more, you know, better versions of the hardware or whatever. But I don't know, it just killed it for me. The battery's dying on me and stuff, especially for something so fundamental as a keyboard. You know, it's like the keyboard should work. It should never fail. It's like your first thing. A mech keyboard? What's a mech keyboard? Oh, mechanical keyboard. Dash keyboard 4? What's that? Right, yeah, is it connected? Is the battery? Do I gotta recharge the battery? Dash keyboard. So what's cool about this thing? Why is this keyboard awesome? Because I definitely would love to get a new keyboard. The psycho acoustic experience? Huh. So just it looks like it has really good feel, is that right? Solid, slim. Good clicky sounds? Uh-huh. Sweet. So it's got this volume knob too, that's kind of cool. USB 3, that's, I need that for sure. I need a USB extension. And key rollover, what's this? Oh. Looks like it's for. Right, yeah, my keyboard is really, I have a horrible keyboard and mouse. If you can, check out my, see if you can even see this. My mouse, it's so hard to see, but I think you can kind of see. It's just, the wires are bare. Like, if I stuck my finger in there, I could probably shock myself. That's how bad and old my mouse is. I think it's from 2006. Cool. I gotta take a look at this. I definitely should take a look at this. I wish they had a split version that had them just slightly. Do they have a split version? No. But cool. It's still cool. Ah. I know, yeah, it's only 5 volts, right? It's a ruler. There's a ruler inside it. So you can measure stuff too. It's always handy. Cool, starting to look a little thicker now. You can defend yourself with it. Yeah. Hey, cool. I'm not the only one that needs a new keyboard. Christmas, yeah. What's up, ladies? What are you at? Come on, let's exchange some gifts. I want a keyboard. I want an awesome sleeping bag. Getting this oh. Yeah. Here we go. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I love getting good quality equipment. I realized that a few years ago. I'm like, dude, I might as well invest in the best quality equipment I can get because shit breaks. But quality stuff breaks less. Mm-hmm. The volume rocker too. Oh yeah, dude. I used to have the dirtiest keyboard. It was brown. I have a white Mac keyboard, and somehow all the keys got brown. Just years of using it with probably super dirty hands. Somehow, I don't know how do your hands get super dirty when you're coding, but. Yeah. Oh, wow, that's a nice little color compliment there. Hacking in dirty codes. Yeah, eating at the computer. Finger oils for sure. What's up, Extreme? Why does Rock need a bike? Right? Oily skin. I'm taking a look at the review, too. Yeah, he needs a bike to be able to get off his ship, man. You started the game on the ship. Cool. I'll check this out. I'll take this review out later. But yeah, you start on your ship in this game, and you start with a shirt on too. And then you take off on your bike, you leave the ship, you go down to the planet's surface, you crash your bike. So that's what I'm working on. That actually that made a good difference right there too. I wonder if these are the same level right here. That, oh, nope. I made that wheel a little thicker. Nice, you started making 2D games? Good for you, dude. It doesn't matter if your pixel art sucks. It doesn't matter, dude. Just make it anyways. And practice for sure. Yeah. In fact, everybody sucks at everything they start. Just about everybody sucks at everything they do at first. I did. I definitely sucked at coding when I first started coding. You should see, I've been looking for, I've actually lost the source code to my very first game I made when I was 14 years old. But that was some horrible code. It was all in one file. We're talking thousands, at least 10,000 lines of code, probably more. And it was all written in MS-DOS Edit in a single file. It was horrible. This is the worst code ever. And my pixel art sucked at first too. My music sucked at first. Everything sucked at first. Yeah, true. Boogie brings up a cool point. Once you got the behavior, everything working, making the art better is even, it's easy. There we go. Okay, now that's lined up. Make sure this is lined up too. Yeah. Okay, cool. We're on to the bike part now. Can make it hover. Hover and stuff. Oh man, I think my bamboo's dying again. Just today. It's going in and out again. I gotta upgrade my bamboo. Gotta get a new one. This thing's dying on me. The wheels fell off. Thanks, Bit Barney. Thank you, Common. Appreciate it, man. It's gonna get better, and I gotta touch up this top part. And what you're seeing is a bike that's gonna float. So let me show you what this will eventually look like. It's gonna like hover. This is all thanks to you guys' suggestions, Arcane, and so it's gonna hover like this. You know, not quite that much. It's gonna be subtle. But yeah, I'm just working on the pieces of it first. So start making it thicker. Lighten that up a little bit. The light's gonna hit it more directly, so. Same with these top bits. That's too much. Too much. Wait, one, two, three. What's up? That's showing me 3 pixels. One, two, three, yeah. Chrome pipes? Chrome pipes, huh? Like, we're at. Like Chrome Pipes, right? I know this is a horrible chrome color, but if it, like here or like here, coming off the end. Oh yeah, a little particle effect. Yeah, that's a good idea too. Yeah. Yeah, it's got a motor for sure in here in the middle. And some sort of like float, you know, magnetic hovering type device or something too. Oh, right. Cool. Nice. Chrome pipes. Cool. We'll try that. What's that? A little Hawaii girl toy on it. The Lenny face. Is that like an inside joke or something? Is that some joke I don't know of? What's a Lenny face? Oh, it's a meme. Oh, all right. Okay. What's up, Bafu? Dude, don't fix it. It's great. I like that he just announces himself sometimes. What do we got? What else? What are the commands we have lately? Oh, yeah, they restart him. Oh. So I'm just cleaning up the pixels. Cleaning up the pixels. You just can't stop, huh? So I like the back. That's starting to look good. But the front is looking too just like it's duplicating pixels, you know. Needs some love. Can't or won't? Both. Either. Okay, so to clean up this front, just trying to imagine how what the best way is to go. I see it needs something more like that. Yeah. Can't stop. Yeah, Born to Slam. Have you seen that video? Oh, yeah. Sorry about that, Arcane. I know it works in people's chat windows, but the actual thing up here with the chat display, I don't know how to get Game Show to do that, to recognize. To recognize the Franker Faces, I would have to install the Franker Faces plugin to like Game Show somehow. I have no idea how to do that. So you haven't checked that out before? That's the best video. Oh, there we go. It's looking all right. So this front. All right, it's getting there. It's getting almost done now. Clean up the inside a little bit now, the engine, the motor, and then try out some chrome pipes. Oh, yeah, I've got both of them. Yeah. I got both Better TV and Franker Faces on my Twitch or my chat. But it just, you know, I'd have to install both of them or you know, whatever, either one of them. I don't know how to get it installed into Game Show and working, but maybe there's a way. It's like I would have to go here to the chat window and mess with its settings. So I don't know. I don't think there's a way I can get it to use plugins. I don't know. Maybe somewhere on the forums for Game Show. Yeah, salad dogs, right? Yeah, thanks, man. Yeah, it's definitely Tron-inspired bike. But now I'm trying to make it a little more unique, a little less Tron, a little more Songbringer. Hmm. These single pixels actually work here. It gives it sort of a riveted look. Yep, gotta check out the null video. Here's the problem, you guys. Dereferencing a null pointer. Okay, if I clean that up too much more, it's going to just look weird. So, let's try some chrome pipes really quick. What's up, Barnabas? It's going great, man. Really great. Making some art. I'm working on this area here with where you're on the ship. So you start here. Yeah, this is a motorcycle, well, flying motorcycle that the Rock, you know, he gets on at the very beginning of the game. You start on your ship, Songbringer. Your ship has just arrived on this planet where the whole goal of Songbringer is just to go to different planets and party. That's all the people do that are on the ship. And so when you're on the ship, you find the cup. There's the droid smith where you can craft items. And there's also this place that's going to be a stage down here. So this is where there's going to be like huge speakers right here. And on this other side over here too, huge giant speakers. A drum set that Jib's going to play. You're going to play guitar. The main hero, Rock's going to play guitar. There's gonna microphone or whatever. So they're a two-piece band, a very like amateur band, not huge or anything. So there's gonna be a small group of people here watching, and that's the beginning of the game. You start here. Yeah, solo cup in space. I never thought of it that way. But yeah, once you're done with playing the show or whatever, it's not gonna be in the newest version of the game. It's not gonna have the song just yet. But I at least wanted to get this whole structure of this area, you know, created and everything, so that you can play this very first bit where you get the cup and you at least hop on your bike and ride away, fly away, basically. So I'm working on the bike right now, trying out some chrome. That's a good question. Why is it called a Solo Cup? So Jib is not from the planet? No, Jib is not from that planet. He's from a Sky City planet. And I think Rock's going to be from the same planet. So they're like, imagine Bespin from Star Wars, just Sky City, everything floats. And somehow, I'm not sure of all the details of the plot or whatever yet. And I don't want to reveal too much at this point because I don't want to ruin anything. But yeah, Jib comes from the Sky City planet. So does Rock. And you get on the board this ship, Songbringer, and it's a super party environment. It's like Burning Man, but in space, basically. That's the concept. And then you eventually come to this planet to party, and Rock is, you know, foolish and picks up stuff that he shouldn't, which almost triggers a war. How are these looking? Are these right? Chrome pipes? Not really chrome, but... I probably don't have these just right, but I think I'm going to leave them off for now. You know, they could be a totally different color. Wait, let's play it a little more. It's Han Solo's cup. 1898. Whoa, that's awesome, dude. So he named the cup in honor of his wife's music. That's amazing. Okay, what do you guys think? Pipes or no pipes? Yeah, Artemis. Yeah, I do use A-Star for pathing. What's up, Cedric? But only on the overworld pathing. Right now, I haven't actually implemented A-Star for entities in the game finding a path. But I think I will, because Jib will have to get past certain things once I finally enable the correct collision detection for Jib. Yeah, that's probably part of it, right? It was the hole. Yeah, I was trying to get that right, but it... I guess you wouldn't be able to see that at all. I feel like it needs it. Maybe that one pixel's all right. Yeah, even that, I know, maybe it's either the color or something. I'm just going to try and put the bike together first without. Right? Cool idea, J2. Yeah. Yeah. Good. Thanks, Chain Revenge. Yeah. Right? Right? It's, yeah. Okay, let's do it like this. So I'm going to make it now so this is animated. So actually, this should be a separate layer. So I make this easier to animate. There we go. Bike, wheels. Great. Now they're separate. So that's... I think that's going to be about it. Yeah, so you can see like one pixel gap at its top height. All right, cool. No pipes for now. No pipes. It's always fun to try ideas like that, though. You know, it's like, okay, how does this look? Two Legacy. All right, all right. Good. I'm glad we're all on the same page about that. It's always good to be on the same page. All right, now, it should hover for a whole, let's try out, first let's do an overall, so try 0.2, forever, yeah, 0.2 is too fast. Maybe 0.5. Even that's a little fast. Helmet. Safety first. So I think their technology is going to have some kind of shielding. So people that ride bikes or whatever, there's actually a shield that protects them when they're riding, which is probably how he crashes the bike into the planet and survives. Now that's a little bit too slow. So maybe more like 7. If there's helmets, there definitely should be a helmet for Jib. There we go. What if Jib is the smart helmet? Oh. Jib's actually the headlight. Now that's two different things, but both interesting ideas. I think both these angles should have some exploration is due here. All right, cool. Time to see what this looks like in the game. There's a create bike tile. Actually, create bike. No, that's not it. There it is, bike percent D. Oh, but that's damn. Oh, I can set it. Can I? Damn it. I don't know if you can set the actual. The animation speed. Yeah, I should create a separate thing. Does he ride or fly alongside? Now that's the most important question. Piggyback? All right, that's going to be totally crazy. It's going to render too fast, but let's see what it looks like. He just falls straight down after leaving space. Oh, it's a land bike only? A side cart. Oh, it did work because I exported all those frames and said. All right, how's it looking? Okay, so I'm gonna come back. I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna take a quick break. I'll be right back, guys. Nice. I like the fly swatter. Salt guns? What are the salt guns? I'm gonna try it hovering one pixel less. Whoops. This is supposed to be. Oh, propagate frame one. Piece of. Oh, I hate propagate frame one. Never use this. It's horrible. Worst feature ever. Bug assault. Bug assault. Whoa. A shotgun spray of regular table salt decimates flies. That's pretty awesome. It's only 35 bucks. Wow. That's cool. Bug assault. I love the name. Yeah, you don't even need a shaker anymore. But add that gun to the game. Oh, I put this in the wrong place. More random for the hover? Let's see how to make it more random. Too slow? What if a couple of these frames are a little shorter than the others? Oh, sorry, man. I keep missing some of the messages. Yeah. Got you. All right, let's try it out. Dude, it repacked the texture so many times, I need to see. Doing it again? Sure you don't want to do it one more time, repacker? Yeah, there we go. All right, cool. All right, let's do an animation where he's getting on the bike. Yeah, so when you get on the bike, the bike will stop moving, so it'll stop at the bottom, right? It goes boom, stops at the bottom, and he swings a leg over, gets on. And okay, so how should Jib do this? Should Jib be f I'm pretty sure Jib's gonna fly along and race him, because Jib can fly. But there's just some other great ideas here. I like the headlight idea, the him on the back, him on the front, whatever. But I think easiest thing to do at first is just have him race alongside. Yeah, well, smoother, faster. I could change that later. All right, so to get the player just to swing his leg over. Sidecar? We got this, our vote for the sidecar. R2-D2 style? What to do? Okay, let's try. Okay, is hard to choose. It sounds like it's gonna be a pain. All right, let's put the player in here. He's standing about here. Let's dial in this a little bit more. Hide him under the top hat. He's the ignition key. Thinking you should be able to get a little closer to the bike. Steal the top hat. Oh, bit of Barney. Now that's a cool idea. Yeah, the characters rocking out in the concert. Yeah, that will take a while for sure. There'll be a lot of characters to do. Okay, one more pixel up. I love that idea. Jib stealing your top hat if you stand there too long. Oh man. That's a great idea. There we go. Okay. Yeah, totally. But I do want them to the crowd to kind of be varied too, so I want to do some sort of alien-looking people, or like just really like Burning Man. Basically, I want people to look like they're at Burning Man. Maximus the greatest. Why does the bike have an idle animation? Because it floats. Because it's a futuristic bike. What if he jumps in the air? I'm just gonna try and swing his leg over first. Okay, so first he's gonna reach out his arm. Rock should transform into the bike. So there's that first frame or second frame where he's like starting to reach towards the handle. Let's do this next one where he's got his hand on the handle. And he's leaning over slightly. Where's his gold chain? He's not a rapper. Oh, what was that? This is tough. I just want him to lean forward like a pixel. Oh, this is kind of a tough animation because he starts. Oh no, I got it. You can have one of his legs just be invisible behind this. Yeah, this will be okay. Well, your dissertation's due on Thursday? Next level rapper. Golden teeth aren't cool anymore in the future, past, or whatever it is. So, like, you get on a bike. He's going to lift his leg. It's DuckDuckGo glasses. What are those? This looks funny. Be a little darker color for the leg that's behind. Okay, next frame. Next frame, say his hand is halfway to the handle. A Bruce Lee kick over the bike? What's that? What kind of Bruce Lee kick? We got so many different kicks he's got. I guess he is going to need to jump a little bit. In order to clear it. It's a tall bike. I made it a little too tall. What's your advice on how on who to follow on Twitter? Yeah. Yeah, and this kind of goes back to what I was saying earlier about being genuine. You know, it's like, who do you really want to follow? Do you really want to follow a bot? And you're going to find out really quick in the first week or two or three, actually the, more like the first month of being on Twitter, where you're really, and you really, you want to engage in the stuff that really is, excites you. You know what I mean? Follow, that's my advice. Only follow people that you are stoked. You're like excited to follow. Don't follow anyone else. And in fact, I would recommend being very choosy about who you follow, because once you start following somebody, it's kind of a dick move to stop following them. You know what I mean? So you want to just only follow the people that you really genuinely want to hear from. And I would filter out. I would have a picky. I would be picky about what you look for in somebody to follow. Like I personally look at everybody's page. Even people I know. I'll look at their page and see how often they tweet. And sometimes I'm like, man, this person's kind of an annoying tweeter. And you'd imagine that in their feed, if they post like 10 things in like 10 minutes, that's going to fill up your feed on Twitter. So you'll get used to it. In the first month, you'll kind of get used to your own, what you prefer to do as far as your Twitter habits, you know. So, you know, don't take my advice as like what you should exactly do, but I would say just do whatever you can to be as genuine as possible and be genuinely following the people that you want to follow, and don't follow anyone that you wouldn't be excited to see, to hear from, you know? Yeah. Yeah, it's like, it's more, and some people tweet more than that, you know? It's like, do you really want to fill up your feed with that? Or do you want to fill up your feed with cool stuff? One of my favorite people to follow was Patrice Lamar. He's got this awesome, rad, let's see if we got, Science Porn's another great one that I love to hear from. Science Porn is so cool. Here it is, Patrice Lamar. He's got all these great, he works for this magazine called It's Art Magazine. And, dude, look at this. He does so many different, he posts so many different articles, and he gets way too few likes and retweets. Cause he's mostly focused on his blog, which is awesome. If you should read some of these articles, he goes into depth and interviews artists and stuff. I find this fascinating. So I love hearing from him. And that's what I would say as far as Twitter goes, just follow the stuff that excites you. Uh-huh. Yeah, and maybe you like that. Maybe you like to follow a bot or two, you know, that keeps you in the loop with stuff. Yeah, right? The It's Art Magazine, that guy's great. And if you like science, definitely check out Science Porn. Okay, I'm thinking here he's actually going to hop a little bit. Wait, no, maybe one more frame before he hops. Yeah, let's do next frame. Vsauce, yeah, I've seen that a couple times. Oh, yeah, Bob Ross Game Dev. Actually, Bob Ross Game Dev is awesome. Richard Lord, I haven't seen before. How many days of school are left? Nice. That's cool. Nice. Yeah, snow closing is great, too. Oh, makes me miss living in an area with snow. Twitter, Richard Lord, who's that? Oops. ISO CPP, is that straight up C++? ISO community? Yeah, it is. Whoa, cool. Right. Yeah, Bob Ross Game Dev. Definitely check that out. So good. Even that one, I liked it a lot when I first saw it. I'm like, okay, this might be a good potential follow. But for my the way my process works is I will look at somebody's account first, and then I'll give it a day or two, and then I'll go, okay, I think I like that person's account still. Then I follow him. What's up, Rocket Bunny? You feel so fulfilled? That's great. Okay, so this frame, he hops up a little bit. And his leg swings over the bike. So this is where he comes on the other side of the bike. And his arm is touching both halves of the bike, or the all this here. Let's get this arm better. Back leg back a bit, maybe. I could do that probably in one of these previous frames. Right. Yeah, there's some great quotes on there. Whoever did that's a genius. Like they really nailed the Bob Ross like mentality really well. I don't know if I can get his arm to stretch that far. Nope, that's not gonna do it. Nope. His arm can go a little farther, but not that far. Space versus tabs debate. Who's Bob Ross? Oh, you got to do a little research, man. Do some research. Figure out who Bob Ross is right now. Tabs for life. I agree. I'm on the tabs. J2. You did? You did? Nice. Yeah. Are they still doing the Bob Ross stream? Okay, I'm gonna skip forward on this last frame and just go to the. I'm just gonna go to the last frame first before I do anything else. Yeah, it's really. They had to cancel it so other streamers can have an audience. Oh man. It's true though. There was so many people on the Bob Ross stream. What was with that? I mean, I thought it was cool too, but it was more just funny to watch what people were trying to say. Wow, 500,000 followers. It was strangely addictive, right? They spammed ruined followed by saved. What's that mean? Yep, this easy needs to lean forward one more pixel here. Challenge, one simple programming task. Ooh. Ruined, saved. Right, what does that mean though? Oh, they spammed. Oh, they spammed ruined followed by saved. Oh. What does that mean though? What does it mean if somebody's just saying ruined, saved? Oh, when you put something new on the, oh, like a tree? Oh, I get it. Oh, right. Okay. Yeah, ruined saved. I get it now. Yeah. I probably saw that and didn't know what it meant. I liked how this one guy commented. He's like, it's funny how. When I come back to the stream, Bob Ross looks noticeably older. That was hilarious. Good old Bobbo. When he beat the devil out of his brush. For my variables, I have a certain way of naming them. Yeah. Not really. I mean, yeah, I guess so. I use Camel Case. You know? Camel Case is really just what I use. You know, there's other ways you could do it. Oh man, I can't even type. Yeah, whatever you prefer. Actually, I like to keep it really simple and use like I and A and B and C and D and X and all those. But you know, I is usually an index. A and B are if I'm swapping stuff or you know, or mixing two values together. C I don't use as much. D is usually a direction. Q is a quadrant. X and Y of and Z, of course. You know what those are. That's kind of how I do it. I try to do that only when it makes sense. You know, you want to keep your code as readable as possible. That's the key word. As long as what you do is readable, you're good, man. Yeah, let them dare. Yeah, there was somebody yesterday who was gonna that's participating. Yeah, the second is the more pure C style. Okay, so his leg is too small. Too small leg. Should come down to like here. Need more chocolate milk. Yeah, and the Global Game Jam, what's that one? You know what I'm really excited about? Oh, I found this recently. I mean, I kind of rediscovered this recently. Is the Awesome Games Done Quick? Have you guys seen this? This stuff is I'm so into this. I love speed runs. Just make it bigger. Does Fallout 4 really do that? So there's this is like a marathon of speed runs, and they do all old school games. There's Summer Games Done Quick and Awesome Games Done Quick. This winter they're doing it in January in Virginia, but I think they switched the location. Right? There's still people on the Bob Ross stream. Yeah. Oh, you watch it on Twitch? Sweet. Yeah, I can't. Oh man, I kind of want to attend that. I mean, just to go and just to watch people speed. I spend hours watching people do speed runs. Speed runs are cool. Okay, what's wrong with this? Is there something wrong with that? He's like, maybe he's a little bit too upright. Maybe he needs to like lean a little more. Yeah, that's it. He needs to lean more. I'm gonna do another frame. Try this again with him. Just is maybe his leg just needs to move back actually. Oh, see that helped. I think his torso has gotten a bit too long as well somehow. Now he looks squatty. Now he's riding a horse. Yeah. You first came to Twitch to watch Ella speedrun Dark Souls? Cool. How fast can people speedrun Dark Souls? What's the time on that? Nice, dude. You know somebody that's doing a race? Cool. Salad Donks? That's awesome. Ghouls and Ghosts. Oh, classic. Sweet. Okay, so up or down? I'm thinking, yeah, that's more relaxed like that. And then, yeah, like this a little bit. The back of his back needs to be a little more curved. Right? Okay, so that's the new one. There's the old. Yeah, that one he looks like he's straight up too proper, too straight. This one he's a little more leaning into it. Saved. Not sure. A quick search says 80% for Dark Souls is 45 minutes. Wow. Whoa. 120? Man. Out. Okay, this animation is progressing along a little bit. Oh, you know what? I need to save this out as a different file now. Save it with all the gray. Save as bike with. Bike with rock on it, rock bike, bike rock. Yeah, bike rock's fine. Bike rock mount. Is that the right word for getting on a motorcycle? Mounting? Of course, it's not right. What's the word for getting on a motorcycle? You hop on Dark Souls 2, any 16 minutes? Whoa. Nice, dude. Yeah, you got Axiom Verge all the way to last. Is the boss 7 the last one? Forget. What it? Yeah, get Axiom Verge. Do you think it'll be on sale? Mount is correct, really? Oh, there's eight. You rock on. Yeah. Whatever. Does it matter? No, it doesn't matter. Okay, so here. Okay, I'm gonna start an animation now. Even though the frames aren't all the way done. Yeah. Some games, I don't know. It's like some games never go on sale. I think Axiom Verge is one of those games. So I skipped a frame there, but I think just to give an idea of what it's going to look like. I really got to try out Ori and the Blind Forest. That's the one I'm like, oh, I got to buy that. Yeah, it's definitely worth it. Yeah, I did too. I totally struggled to pay $20. I was like, man, that's kind of a steep price for a retro game. But it was totally worth it. Agreed. Avast. Yeah, I'm on my second run of the game, but I haven't been playing it because I've been just coding so much and making so much art for the Indie Cup this Thursday. But I would really want to play it again. So yeah, there's some missing frames in the middle, but this is like kind of working so far. Yeah. And now it just needs those middle frames. And I would like to see the whole thing go down a pixel at the end. So right here at the end, it starts here. Here, the whole bike and whoops. The bike goes down a pic whoops. Deselect, deselect. D freaking select. There we go. Down a pixel, and so is our hero. And then make this go here. So it's like the whole bike goes down a sec for a bit. Do the fiery teleport onto the bike? Yeah, the keyframes are looking good, right? There we go. Yeah, that's cool. I love that. Oh, yeah. Okay, so next thing, just getting those middle frames, and that's it. So I think it's just. Long stream? Am I haven't been streaming too long? What's up, Pedro? Hello, welcome to the stream, Pedro. I'm working on the bike. Check it out. I got this last night. I was working on the areas and stuff for the Songbringer ship. So there's five different areas you can go to. Psh, don't tell him to look at the time. that's the new bike. But basically, you. Eventually, you're gonna start the game playing a song here in this stage area down here. It's 2:20 already? Whoa. Yeah, so there'll be a huge speaker right here, another speaker over here. There'll be like a drum set, a guitar, a microphone, and people in this in the crowd rocking to your amateur music. So that's the beginning of the game, but I'm not gonna have it for this alpha version. But I do at least want to have you to be able to explore Songbringer a little bit more. So you get the party cup over here. This is going to be an observation room here. So there's going to be giant windows over here on the left side, just big, big windows looking out on the planet or the stars or if you're in space. And then the hangar over here. First up here is the droid smith as you're already familiar with. And then over here, there's gonna be, this is the hangar, or, hangar in quotes, whatever. It's just got your bike right now. But I think there'll be some windows in here as well and an exit to the right. So basically, I'm making animation right now where you hop on the bike and then you fly off this way. So yeah, it's not gonna be complete. It's not gonna be like the final version of the game yet, but at least you'll be able to explore this area. So right there, right. Yeah. Well, that needs a frame, and then this needs at least a one frame. I'll start by mixing these two frames. Thanks, Pedro. Have I really been streaming over 2 hours already? Oh, wow. Time flies when you're having fun drawing stuff. Okay, I'll go a little longer, though. This will be a long stream. Let's mix those two frames. Hey, thanks, Jay Shulman. You go back up. Oh, back up to the ship? Ah. Yes, you go back to the ship. Dialogue trees with members between each? What? What you mean? What's that? Say that. Sorry. Say that again about dialogue trees. I do need to do some kind of really, really long stream at some point. Maybe I'll do that when it's getting close to the beta. Do a 24-hour stream. But don't quote me on that. Not yet. Let me surprise you. Confirmed. It's gone. Oh, confirmed. Okay, I'm imagining if these dissolve together. I'm going to try this technique of dissolving two frames together to see what it would look like. Ah, that did not work. Okay, I'm going back to my other strategy of just doing it the way I always do it, where I just draw. Dissolving two frames together is not really the aesthetic of this game anyway. So it's halfway between that frame. In fact, this frame right here is just, I'm not sure if we even need it. Let's put it all the way up there. This frame here. It's kind of like his body is in the same position as this. You need to take a vacation for that day. All right, I'll definitely announce it, but I'm saying. Thesis supervisor, what's that? Oh, Kingdom? Totally. Have you played it yet? Everybody quote him. So you speak to people on the ship, learn some things about them, whatever. Then when you beat a level dungeon, you go back to that person. Maybe their story progresses. Yes. There's a procedural dialogue system already I started. So you got dialogue that is all in this story file. And it's procedural. So it can require certain flags for a certain bit of dialogue to be triggered. So the way that would work is when you're on the ship, it would trigger a certain amount of dialogue because you don't have certain items or you haven't been there yet. And then once you've been there, or you've done certain things, you've gotten certain items, then it would trigger some new dialogue. So that's how that will work. And it's actually a pretty simple system. There's a whole article on it by the guy from some guys from Steam, actually. Yeah. You bought it, but you haven't played it yet? Yeah, I've seen some gameplay of it. It looks pretty good, but I'm wondering how fun it is to actually play it, you know? All right, I'm thinking this frame, he isn't quite touching that. Maybe his face is still facing us a little bit. And his leg is still a little bit up in the air a little more. See that? Yeah. You love lore and speaking to people to find out stuff in games. Cool. Yeah, I'm a sucker for nice pixel art too. There's definitely some rad art in Kingdom. In fact, I'm quite inspired by their artwork for their shader effects and everything for the water. I really want to do better water in Songbringer. Oh, hey, that one frame right there really helped. In fact, now it just needs one more frame between that and that. Or maybe just this one needs to move up a little. Oh yeah, dude, that's it. That's all I needed. Cool, I'm liking this. How are you guys liking this? Is it looking good? Oh wait, one thing. He needs to look forward at the very end. Yeah, totally. Yeah, great. Well done, Pix. Isn't Kingdom published by Adult Swim? Is that right? Right? Yeah. Swimmingly. Such a rad word. Oh. This here. Whoops. Oh, I duplicated the wrong frame. Yeah, the bounce helps, right? Too many Big Macs. Oh, Raw Fury. Oh, okay, so it's not Adult Swim. Okay, so I duplicated the wrong frame here and it messed this animation up right there. Okay, there. So that frame we don't need. We want to duplicate this frame. Here it's down. There, I think it's fixed. Okay, so I'm starting to feel the pains of hunger, guys. Yeah, good night, Jonah. Sleep tight, man. A young Abe Lincoln on a Tron light bike. That's exactly what it is. What's up, Kanata? Yeah, and so I've been already been streaming over my time here, and I'm getting hungry. But so I would normally go and put this in the game and try this out because it's so close to trying this out, right? All I got to do is publish this out in the game. But the trick is I got to swap out the player and this new art or whatever. So I gotta get this working and stuff. So this will take another hour probably just to get this right. So, you know, he hops on the bike and the bike flies off and everything. But at least the animation's done. So this is, I'm pretty happy with this animation here, how it turned out. You're hungry too? Right on. Yeah, so that's it for today's stream. If you're new to the stream, if you're just you're checking us out, you're like, what the heck is this? This is a it's a procedurally generated Zelda-like game. What I just showed you in the game there was a very small part of the game. That's like a very small part of the game on the ship where you start the game on your sci-fi spaceship. And then you actually, there's a whole planet to explore, and there's dungeons, there's 9 dungeons. So it's like, it's kind of like Binding of Isaac with an overworld. That's how some people put it. I think it's more like the original Legend of Zelda, only if it were procedurally generated and had a little more modern artwork. So anyways, that's it for today. The game's called Songbringer, and I'm always streaming every day about this time. Best way to catch me right when I start is to follow, because I don't always start at exactly the same time. So see you guys.